Maseches Bavikame, Daf Yud Amud Beis, Bezel Shem Nasev and Etzliach. Let's, before we start today's shiur, which is Yud Amud Beis, the second line, Maskif L'Rav Pope, we're in the Maskif. We have to know what the story, where are we holding now, what's going on, what's the Inyan. So, I'm sorry that the screen is shaking for some reason. Okay, the story is like this. The Mishnah made a statement. The Mishnah made a statement, and the statement was, the Mishnah said that echshati b'miktzas nizkoi, chavti b'tashlum nizkoi, kechshor kol nizkoi. If I was machshir, if I enabled a little bit of the nezek, a small part of the damage, I'm chayev, I'm liable, I'm responsible, as if I created the entire thing, as if I created the whole nezek together, and not the other person. And that's a very, very rare case. In other words, when do we have a case in which a person does the small bit, the small thing, and yet he's chayiv as if he did the whole thing. And we found one case, and one case only. That case was what we said yesterday. The case was with, as opposed to Ebi, with, who says that? That was, just a Brisa, anonymous Brisa. The Brisa said, a person who dug a bore, a pit of nine tefachim, and that bore has the ability to damage people and injure them. Excuse me, animals are more in the Indian over here, not people. And then came another person, of course his name is Shimon, joking. And Shimon, he dug one more pit, one more tefach. He turned it from a damaging bore into the bore of death, the valley of death. Yeah, he turned it into a boar that can halachically kill. Chachomim alleged death to that boar because it crossed the red line. He crossed the divide. He crossed the red line from a damaging boar into a killer boar. Killer boar, that's a good one. A killer boar, a killer whale. Yeah, it's a killer boar. We will make a movie about the killer boar, make a lot of money. And if he made it from a damaging boar into a killer boar, then in a person, an animal fell inside, and the animal that fell died, is chayv on everything, according to Chachomim and to Rebbe. And Chachomim also say that even if the person, even if the animal was damaged, was nizok, still is chayv exclusively only him. And that's a special din there, Sakosuv, yeah, that koyre achar koyre is chayv. You always go after the second one, and the second one that turned it from a damaging boar into a killer boar, it's a boar of Misa, he is chayv as if he did everything, and the first one is potter. You can ask why, it's a very nice question, we're not in North Korea yet, and therefore you can ask, but Lemaisa, this is how the Torah views it. And that's a chiddush. However, let's say one dug a boar of 8, and the other one made 9, they're both chayv. Or let's say one dug a boar of 10, and the other one 20, 15, whatever, they're both chayv. Yeah, partners in crime. Because they both have parts in it, right? Mashenken, if you cross the line from 9 to 10 and you turned it into a whole new reality of a killer boar, a boar that can halachically is considered as a boar that can kill and the person will be chayv the balabo, you're the exclusive chayv on that for everything according to Rabbanon. And that is what our Mishnah is saying. Then the Amoraim asked different questions. Why didn't you have another example? We're basically now in the middle of finding, of looking, of searching for what another case where another case that would fit the criteria, another case that would fit that text of the Mishnah, that if I did a little bit of damage and I came after another damage, but I did the other bit, I crossed that the 9 yards, whatever, on the 9 tefachim, I should be chayv, the last one should be chayv, and not the first one. We're looking for another case like that, and so far we didn't find. Why? Because either the cases were wrong, or the cases were too simple. And this is a very good class. I would teach this Gemara, I think, for people who just stepped into Oras HaMeach or Isha Torah. This is a very good Gemara that teaches you what Gemara is all about. The Gemara doesn't like wrong facts, and the Gemara doesn't like facts that are too simple. Right? The Gemara wants something that's emesdik and chiddush. So far, we haven't found that. Now, we're going to talk about the case of the people who sat on the bench, and then the people who sat on the bench, and they, the bench cracked, and they, well, the bench broke because of overweight. We, before starting this year, we already have commercials We have the peanut gallery with questions, our good friends. Yes, sir. Now starting to hear. Yudom Udbeis, Maseches Bava Kama, excited. Maskif Lo Rav Papa. Rav Papa now is attacking the Braisa. Why didn't the Braisa tell us the following case? Vayika Hodetanya. There's another case that's brought down in another Braisa. What does it say? Chamisha Shiyoshua Safsal Echod. Five people were sitting on one bench. Okay, a parancha of the Hasidim, they sat on one bench, and five people sat on one bench. Veloshavu, they didn't break it. Uba echad veyoshavolov veshavoy. The sixth person came, and as he came in, let's assume it happened a few minutes later. As he came in, he sat on it, he broke it. Ha'achron chayev. The last one is chayev. Sounds like the last one is chayev, and not the ones before. Okay, and lechoyro, that is similar to our case because the five people, if he would have sat there alone, nothing would have happened. Of course, he's the excessive weight, but if not for them being there, nothing would have happened. But he's the one that did the last bit. That's, if anything, that's a little bit more similar to the minyan. In other words, everyone came, but then he's a makir bepatish, kepshuta is makir, boom. He came, he put his nice, body over there, krach. It happened, so he's chayev. Rama Rav Popeh. Now, Rav Popeh noted on that. Kigon Papa Bar Abba. I'll give an example. What kind of guy would be the guy that sits there and he's the sixth guy that breaks it? Somebody like Papa Bar Abba, which is a person who's heavyweight. Yeah, says Rashi, Papa Bar Abba is a person who, Shayo Baal Boso. He was Baal Boso. He was a heavyweight. He was a... You're not allowed to say the word fat. Obese is more than fat. It's worse. The kids are maisa. So there are two questions. What's the comparison? Yeah, the comparison could be good in Havamina. You have a case here of an accumulative nezek, but the last guy is a boom. He is a last blow. And that could fit our Mishnah, right? He's the one who did a little bit of nezek. But then at the end of the day, right, it's only him that is the excessive weight, the ones before. If they would have sat there their entire lives then, and nothing would have happened. It's really him, that's his fault. He's overweight and excessive weight. Okay, that I can take. Why is he comparing it to Papa Baraba? Why is Rav Papa telling us that Papa Baraba would be a good example for somebody who sits there? I saw it yesterday in the Meiri. I'm too lazy to open the Meiri. I look in the Chochma Meiri. And what does it say there? The Miri brings down, and that's brought down actually La Locho, a Machloikas. Some people say that in general, if regular people, nice and slim, like from the Coca-Cola ads, if those people sit on the bench, this Coca-Cola is so healthy. Yeah, if they sit on bench and the bench breaks, they're not Mechuyev, because it's like Shoy'el. Shoy'el was always chayv on anything, somebody borrowed something. And let's say I come to Tzvi's house, and assuming I was thin, I wish, yeah, and I would sit on the bench, and I didn't do anything crazy. I didn't, swing on it, and I just sat on it, and it would break unexpectedly. So then I'd be potter, because a regular person who's regular weight and uses the chair regular way, it's like by a shoyel meisa machmes melocho. Regular use. If I use it the regular way without doing anything funny, and it happened, it's not my fault. Only if the person is overweight. The person has excessive weight, then he's chayev. So some Rishonim learned, the Miri brings down the other Rishonim that he doesn't agree with. Yeah, but apparently some people in Shulchan Aruch, I saw that's an opinion. He says if somebody overweight, the whole story is about overweight people, but if the person that came and sat and it cracked under his body, then what do we say? Then if he's fat, then he's chayev, because he's not meant to sit there. It's too small for him and he's too big for that. Other Rishonim say no. Other Shonim say, no, even if you sat on it, you have to be careful. If you sat on it and you're the sixth person, whatever, even if you're nice and slim and you're out of the dietitian, whatever, you just lost, 50 kilo, if it happened because of you, that you sat on it and it's your weight that caused the thing to crack open and fall apart, then you're chayv. So why is he mentioning Rav Papa? Oh, some people say, Kigon Rav Papa, Papa Rabba, he's telling me halacha. Yeah, Rav Papa didn't say juicy, funny example. like I sometimes do. You know who that fat guy, if he would have said there, that's the kind of guy we're talking about. Yeah. He's telling us halacha. Somebody like Papa Abba, somebody's overweight, on about him the halacha is said. According to those who say only overweight. According to the people who say that a slim person will be the same halacha, Enochanan, he says, Amir, it's derech tzachus. He's saying it as a funny thing, as a cute thing to tell the Talmidim. Sometimes you're allowed to say cute, funny examples to keep everyone awake. And he was telling them, and it wasn't Lashon Hara, I guess, back then to be fat wasn't considered as something bad. So to say that so-and-so would sit on it, he was just giving them an example that was more vivid, that's all, according to the Miri. In any event, that's the example we want to take. So the question is, why don't we use this case in the Mishnah? We're now in the question, if this case is so good and fits a description of a final blow that caused everything to fall retrospectively, everyone added to the weight. But the last blow, boom, was a sixth guy. Great. So why doesn't the Braisa mention this case? Why do we only throughout the sugya, if you notice, we stick all the time, like so very adamantly, to the case of nine tefachim and ten tefachim and bor? Why can't we use this case also? Says the Gemara, Echidami. I'll tell you why. Because what exactly is the case of the tenth guy, of the sixth guy of the bench, of the overweight guy? If without him, lo itbar, what's itbar? With a break, like ishbar, very good, taf and shin are interchangeable. If without him, it wouldn't have broken, they would have sat there for the entire shiur, the entire 4-hour long shiur, they would all sit on the bench, and forever and ever, nothing would have happened. Pshita, then of course, it's clear that only because of his heavy presence, it happened, that it's not a chiddush. Then we don't like those things that are not chidushim. Every guy would tell me, well, he's his fault, he's the last guy. Ella, the beloved you, nami itbar, and if it would have broken anyways without him, if the, let's say, the bench was so flimsy, and without him would have broken anyways, then my COVID, what did he do? Then what do you want from him? Again, the same logic, it's either too simple or it's wrong. And therefore, because this brisa doesn't make sense, we don't want to connect this brisa to our prized Mishnah that talks about the last guy who did a little bit of nezik. Because this brisa doesn't make sense to us. The obvious question is, what? What do you mean? But it's okay, it doesn't make sense in our Mishnah, but that brisa alone doesn't make sense. In other words, it's like saying, you know, this boy is not good for this yeshiva because he's terrible, but he's good for the other yeshiva. Why is he good for the other yeshiva? In other words, what's the story? If this brisa doesn't make sense to you, so you're not connecting it to our Mishnah, but why is this brisa written at all? You have to make sense of this brisa as of itself. You don't want to connect it to us, Beseder, but why is this brisa in Bechlal in Shas? As the Gemara asks, Shoif, Shoif, at the end of the day, after all said and done, Mesnisa, Eicha Mitalza. How do you explain the Mishnah? Is this Mishnah, is either, again, if the guy, nothing would have happened without him, and he's clearly the one, you see, Chosh Rebal Bosa, Tzedek Lefon of Yehalech, he has something walking ahead of him, And what? And he's sitting there, and what? And it fell, then what's a chiddush? Of course it's chayim. And if it would have happened without him, you call the engineer, the safsal engineer tells you it would have happened anyways, and what do you want from the guy? Or at least maybe the shutfus, why only him? So it's a difficult brisa to understand. Leave us alone, just explain this brisa bifnei atzmo, is of itself. Suggestion?
What happens if the busser was sitting there and then like a 50-kilo guy comes along?
Oh, Lichor, it's the same. Would be the same. It's the same. It's the same. Very good. And Chnami. Says the Gemara, lo itzricha. No, we do have to mention this brisa. What's the story? It's a rather easy answer, actually. The belav ihu, without him, havi mitzvah betrei shoi. Without him being there, says the engineer, 2 hours it would have taken until it would have broken. It would have happened anyways. The five guys that were sitting there, you know, for a 3-hour long shiur or tish or whatever, no paranches, unless they were sitting down now. Betrei shai, after 2 hours it would have happened anyways. The hashta itba b'chadasho. After a heavy set guy, number six, or not heavy set, after the sixth guy came, it happened earlier. He accelerated it. He brought it in earlier. It happened earlier. So what? The Amri Lei, now they can tell him, you are the only one chayav here. You are the only person that's chayav in the story, not us. Why? Because they can tell him, ilav at, if not for you, havi yatvinan tfei purta, we would have said a little bit more, tfei more, purta a little bit, would have said a bit more, the kaimin, we would have stood up. In other words, if not for you, yeah, you brought it earlier. You brought it, let's, instead of 1 hour, it happened within half an hour. Within half an hour, we would have stood up to take coffee and come back or go or something. You brought it earlier, therefore, really, it's your fault. Yeah, that's what they can tell him, and that's why he's chayiv, and he's the only exclusive one that's chayiv. Correct the Gemara, wait a second, now comes the lawyer of him. Comes the lawyer of Mr. Sixth guy, last guy, the lema lehu, and why can't he tell them, ilav atun bedidi, if not for you, atun, if not for you, plural, if not for you guys, bedidi, together with me, lahav mitzvah, would have broken, why didn't you stand up? Why didn't you stand up? You could have stood up. I sat there, I have the right to sit there, the sixth place, you stayed there, and lemaisa, at the end of the day, it's also your weight, so at least be mishtatev. Yeah, if I was there alone, one of you, you're so concerned about safety, one of you is welcome to stand up and take turns, and I'm also a human being. So, Mimela, why is it only me? It's you and me together. At the end of the day, it was accumulated weight of everybody else. Answers the Gemara, and then we're going to see Rashi. Today, we're going to have two Rashis to see. Answers the Gemara, and that's the final answer. Loi, tzricha, there is a chiddush here. And by the way, this is la halacha. This is true la halacha. If the sixth guy is the last guy that sat, and right away it cracked open, broke, then he's chayiv, because he's excessive weight. Again, if, let's summarize before we come to the final answer. If you have a nice, more or less steady bench, and it says, look, in the elevators, and the lifts, and the elevators up to six people, I don't know, 500 kilo, I don't remember, and another guy came to the lift, and he's the last one that came in the 13th floor, and then something happened to the lift, it's his chayiv. Yeah, that's for sure. Nothing would have happened to the lift without Mr. Excessive Weight. Then excessive weight, he has to pay. That's for sure. That's Shulchan Aruch. And on the other hand, if we know that it would have happened without him, in other words, if they're all together in it, yeah, and then it's all chayv together. If it's not him, it's not excessive weight. In other words, all together in the story equally, it's not. It's 500 kilos and only 500 kilos are there and it broke. Yeah, so if they're overweight, everyone would say, the chayv to pay everyone together. But when do we have a case that he's chayv alone and it's a chiddush? We're looking for a case that only is chayv, but it's a chiddush case. To say that if the lift can hold five adults and he's the sixth one, the shtuptin, of course he's chayv. That's not a chiddush. We're looking for a chiddush. When do you have a chiddush case that is still only chayv and him and not them? Answers the Gemara, a more unique kind of case. Lo, it's richa. Line starts with the word de behadi. De behadi de samich beutovar. He didn't actually sit there. You know what he did? He's a very friendly, big guy with a big smile. All five guys were sitting in the bench, listening to the shir. He's coming from behind, hugging them, and he stands over them, and he's samich. He's like leaning against that little poor bench, and he doesn't let them get up. He doesn't let them get up. He's so friendly. How are you doing, guys? He does not let them stand there. And he's shoymech. And then the bench broke. The bench broke when he actually sort of, you know, pushed his weight against the table, the bench, and he made them sit there. And it's absolutely, they were like, we want to go already. No, you can't go. I'm here, you know, forcing you to stay over here and listen to the shir of my rabbi. So then what? Then the thing broke. Fragment more pshita. That's also poshut, of course. He's mamish bringing all five people there. He's mamish the only one. They could have been they've been interested to get out of the place. He's pushing them. It's only him, and he's pushing on the chair, on the safsal. So what's the chiddush? Of course he's the only chayv, the only culpable one, the only culprit. Answers the Gemara. Now the tema, you could have argued, his koyach is not his body. In other words, he didn't sit there. It's only his koyach. He forced them. But he himself didn't actually sit there with his ganza body or on it. He was standing over, making them sit there and pushing them on it. So it's not his goof. It's not his own body. It's his koyach. It's his force, his power, his koyach that caused it. Maybe that's not considered his own ezek. Maybe it's like a groma kind of thing. Kamash malan, the koychoy kegufoy dami. The koyach is like the goof, as opposed to groma, which is an indirect. This is direct. This is direct enough. He's pushing them on the table, like making them stay on the safsal, on the bench, and they are his koyach. It's like his own body, and therefore he's chayev. He's an exclusive chiyuv here, and that's the only chiddush here. And continues the braisa, the koyach the goof etovar koychoy nami. Toval, whenever his body would have broken it, his koyach also breaks it. It's his, I don't know, 120 kilos that actually are pushing the table indirectly, but directly enough for us to be mechayvim. So that's the case. Now, the question is, so what's the maskana? This braisa makes a lot of sense. It's a very sensible braisa. It's talking here about koyach. It's talking here about a person that came last and he's not sitting. Right, he's not sitting there. He's a person who, because if he would sit there, just accelerates it, still everyone is chayv. You could have stood, you could have, would have, should have, all this blaming, everyone's chayv together. But in the case where he pushed everybody to sit there and he's koyach who caused it, he's chayv. Now the question is, we're walking the tightrope, if you remember. We're looking for a very, very, very unique case over here. We need a case where it should make sense, be right, be a chiddush, but should also not fit our Mishnah. It shouldn't fit our Mishnah, right? That's fair. Because we, one of the parameters of this Gemara is we have to answer why didn't the Braisa connect this Braisa to our Mishnah? Why is there a mismatch? Why is there a disconnection between this case and our Mishnah? Why can't this fit the description of our Mishnah of a person who came and did the final Nezek and everybody else is Chayav? Says Rashi. Yeah, Pshita. Two Rashis here. Look at Rashi Pshita at the beginning of the sugya. Rashi Pshita is the middle of the not the middle. It's about 12, 13 lines from the beginning of the narrow lines. Rashi Pshita. Okay, I recommend you look inside. Yeah, Pshita. Deloy dami lebo sharisham gom nezikin v'horak chetzio eruboy. Oh, which means there's a difference between the case of the bowl and the case of the safsal. And that's why I took a little bit of exception when you said about the minyan. The case of the safsal, yeah, lefi, the beginning of the understanding, the way we understood safsal at the beginning, everyone set, would have stayed like that forever. They could have stayed there forever, sitting there watching the shir. Everything would have been amazing honky-dory. He came and he broke. You can say, well, it's also their weight, right? But he's the Maki Bepatish. Now, this kind of case cannot fit our Mishnah. Why? The case of our Mishnah is a case where damage was already done by the ninth Fochim guy. The ninth Fochim guy, is he completely innocent? No. Because he is already, it's like half a minion. The ninth Fochim guy caused Misa, Miktsas Misa, where he is sold in Ezekiel and in Shabbos, Hako Miktsas Misa. When you hit someone, it's like a mini death. Yeah, it's like a minimized, like a smaller, minor kind of death. Yeah, when we give someone a blow, a few blows together could kill the person, as we'll see in the next case. And therefore, our case of the safsal is like the minyan. When you join, people come to the minyan. Oh, here came the 10th guy. The minyan is supposed to start 3:15, 3:30. Everyone's going crazy. The 10th guy, somebody you never know. You don't even know he's Jewish, but he's Jewish. Yeah. And what? Now, with the 10th guy, 9 guys without 10th guy is nothing. The safsal, 9 guys without the 10th would be garnished. The 10th guy or the 6th guy, the last guy, it's true that without the first ones, nothing would have happened. But without the last one, nothing would have happened either. The case of Bor is more mechudesh. We're looking in the Mishnah for a case, miktsas nizkoi, meaning that there was already major nezik done by the first guy. Nachon? Because the first guy, when he created 9 tfachim, that is damaging. It's considered bad enough halachically that if damage happens to the animal, it's considered as you are chayav for the damage. Moreover, I'm not reading Rashi in stuff. Maybe I'll see the next Rashi soon. Yeah. Yeah. Mashiach, you get the difference? We're looking for a case where one person created real Nezek, but not complete Nezek. It's bad enough for damage, not bad enough for death. Okay, so you. Yeah, Mashiach, and then came the other guy, did one tiny bit, crossing the line from mini damage to super damage, he's chayav on everything. Wow, that's a chiddush. And it does not appear in the case of safsal. In the case of safsal, that's not the case. Because in the first case of safsal, everyone could have sat there forever, ever living happily ever after on that bench for life. Nothing would have happened. So the last guy created from nothing everything, even though it's also their accumulation. Right? But without him, nothing would have happened. They would have sat there very safely. And that case for us is not good enough. Now, I'm continuing Rashi for 1 second. El mishum achiyu de mifta, do amalei, lab ata umachzik mitzik, sorry, if not for you, it would be an ezek, v'lo hava mayis. In other words, The last guy can say, the first guy can say to the other guy, well, the bull wouldn't have died in the boar. In the case of the boar, we say, listen, you caused death, so even though I caused damage, but you caused death, you're the only chai. That's a much bigger chiddush. The first guy's off the hook is a big chiddush, like Jeffrey was asking. But Shane can hear, they didn't break anything until he came. That's the beginning of the sugya. Yeah? Thank you for your patience, I appreciate it. And now we'll see also another Dibur Maschil where it says Belavi Uave Mitzvah Betrei Shai. Yeah, this is the next stage in the sugya. Again, every stage of the sugya, we have to know why it doesn't fit into our Mishnah. Let's read the next Rashi. Rashi, we skipped a few Rashis. One Dibur Maschil. Remember the other case, the other tzad we had? Without him, he would have broken within 2 hours. He brought it earlier into 1 hour. So we wanted to say he's chayev, but then we rejected it. Says Rashi, now that's a chiddush. Even though it would have happened anyways, because he accelerated it, he's the only one chayev. Although afterwards we rejected it. We couldn't have mentioned it in our Mishnah. Why? It's not considered like, even though those people, now this is more of a chiddush. In this case, what are we saying? If not for him, he would have broken after 2 hours. So they're not such cutesy, nothing completely innocent people. If they would have remained there long enough, 2 hours, it would have happened. His presence brought it earlier. So why can't that fit into our Mishnah? Here, we have mini Nezek and major Nezek. That is similar to our Mishnah. Why isn't it mentioned? There was mini Nezek of something would have happened in a long time, and major Nezek that he brought it earlier. Why can't you mention that in the Mishnah? Says Rashi, brilliant thing. It doesn't fit into the words of I was machshir, I created a little bit of Nezek. Why? He created the entire Nezek. Why? The first ones, at the end of the day, when it broke, they didn't break anything, and he broke more. It's not like it started cracking by them and continued crack by him to completion. Wow. This rush is major. In the case of Nezikin, we say that the final death of the behemah, the actual death itself is comprised of two elements. The ninth tfachim, the heat, by the bull, we'll see later in sugya, is a machlokes. Why do animals die in pits that are not so deep? It's not a 5 kilometers. What? Bad air, very good. Machlokes, is it because of the chavot or the boom? You know, they broke the neck because, let's say we didn't see exactly what happened, yeah? But it's because of the actual injury of hitting the ground? Or is it because of the bad air? Because inside, you know, the suffocate, and that's not good air to stay. Now, the guy who dug the ninth tfachim, as the animal fell, heads in, yeah, whatever, it fell like that, the ninth tfachim started already to kill it. And the tenth tefach finished the killing. That's not the case of the safsal. In the safsal, it would have, should have, would have happened in 2 hours, and he brought it earlier. But Lamaisa, only when he sat there with a choshuv frakin Hamburg and 200 kilos, that's when the thing happened. Mashenkin with a bow, no. It really started with the first guy. Mamish, the killing started with the first and continued with the second. It's like one guy hit him, then the other guy hit him more. That is a much bigger chiddush, and that's a chiddush we're looking for. And therefore, the case of the Safsal is lo matim to our Mishnah whatsoever. Yitzchok, what do you want to tell us? Please share with us.